You're watching Dealing Room, and there is no significant significance to the technical level we are at today. But as I said, if we head back another 60 points, then of course we're testing supports once again. But whether that happens or not, let's just wait and see how it pans out. Automobile stocks, though, maybe a different picture. As I said, now the question is, is there going to be selling there? Because if somebody reports very high numbers, the general thought process will be, well, you just pre-built before November 8th, and that's all that happened, which means you even sucked out the sales from December. If that is the case, then we don't know what December looks like, because this is the first month where, you're not going to be able to utilize any of that cash. So it'll be very interesting to see. Now, that's on the two-wheelers, on the four-wheelers. But the two-wheelers anyway got hit immediately because, much of it was cash. So, how much billing can you do? So we'll see. And then what is their impact in December? Mandar, good morning. Thanks very much for joining us. For starting out, I wanted to take your thoughts on if you have any significant technical level at the moment on the Nifty itself. But the bank Nifty, I was a little concerned yesterday because, again, it couldn't hold the 18,600 level and started to fall down.
Good morning, Ashu. Basically what is happening right now is in case of the Nifty, we've witnessed a 300 to 350 point up move in the last 8 trading sessions. And this bounce back was basically due to the sharp fall which was witnessed earlier after 8th of November. And at current levels, I think the Nifty has this tough resistance at 8250, the highs that the Nifty tried to test yesterday. And if Nifty does not manage to break this resistance of 8250, then I think it could move lower to test 8100, 8000 once again. And this, I think, could be because of the mood turning cautious now as we are heading to an eventful month of December, and the cautiousness could limit the upside moves. And without fresh negatives or further negatives, the downsides could also be capped at recent lows between 7,900 and 7,990. So not much of action. Therefore, in the coming few days, I think the index could witness a dull trade. Specific activity could continue. Today being the last day of the week, the interest could be on the lower side. Same is the case with the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty also has this resistance, rightly said, at 18,600. So, quite possibly, Bank Nifty could trade between 18,600 and 18,150, the lows that it made recently. The move for the index could be range-bound as we head into the RBI policy next week.
Mandar, usually before we run into December 31st, it's also a time for really dressing up mutual fund net asset values. So usually people would say it's rather difficult that the market may have a downside because, if the downsides usually come in January and stuff. Is it possible that that window dressing part of it, takes you to some kind of index management? And so the index actually, so maybe the overall market starts to remain flat, but largely the index kind of continues to move up.
So I think the index this time, the index could be more of into a range-bound trade. And the reason as to why I see this is, what we've witnessed is, along with the Nifty, we've also witnessed corrections in the index heavyweights. And most of the index heavyweights are trading on support levels. Now, the reason as to why I say that it will stay range-bound is that the upsides are limited in these stocks. For the Nifty to move up, it will need support from Bank Nifty, which is not being witnessed. So if I look at individual banking stocks, then the stocks are mixed. They are trading more of range bound. And with this current demonetization playing on till 31st of December, I think the Bank Nifty would continue to trade range bound. And that's what would make the Nifty to get into a range bound trade. Yes, there's surely index management which is happening. So whenever you have selling happening in index heavyweights, you have Reliance trying to manage or trying to hold the index up. So basically, a more range-bound trade would be witnessed during this month is what I feel.
Mandar, same thoughts, if I may, first on just the banks. Do you feel comfortable technically being in any private sector bank at the moment? Because, you know, if I was following a trend, I certainly can't find the uptrend.
Yes, Ashu rightly said. See, most of the banks are not showing any kind of trend right now. So basically, they are stuck in levels, between levels. In private banks, the weakest one is Axis Bank right now. It's trading on support of 460. I think if this 460 level is broken, then we could have a 10% downside from here on. So therefore, at current levels, these most of these banks are range bound. So for example, if I look at PSU banks, Bank of Baroda is range bound between 158, 160, and if the that level support level of 160 and 150 is broken, then it will fall down to 140, 135. Canara Bank is range bound between 290 and 335. Orient Bank is range bound between 110 and 135. SBI is range bound between 250 and 265. So maybe so most of these banks are range bound right now, and I think they are range bound because they are expecting something. So quite possibly going forward, though right now there's we don't have an opportunity to get into a trade in these stocks. I think next week we could have an opportunity, because one of these levels are going to be broken, and then in that case, short-term traders could surely find an opportunity in getting into a trade. It could be a long trade, it could be a short trade. So as of now, the stocks are trading without a trend. But yes, as and when one of these levels are broken, we surely could get into a trade, and that could be a good opportunity for the short term.
Mandar, what's your thought about, technically BPCL, HPCL, oil, all look fine, but which is the best spot you see between BPCL, HPCL, Mangalore refineries, oil, Cairn, India, Petronet, LNG and ONGC?
See, what has happened is with the crude going up, most of the oil marketing companies, these OMCs have dipped down. ONGC right now has a resistance at around these 299-300 levels. If that's broken, then ONGC could head higher to 330. In case of MRPL is trading above crucial level of 92. Till the time it trades above 92, the next levels could be 110. So that's a level which one needs to watch. HPCL has dipped down. HPCL has got a support at around 440, 435. So quite possibly it could, if that's broken, then on the lower side, it could move down to 420, 400 levels as well. So these stocks are looking weak as of now. BPCL also has a support at around 620. If 620 is taken, then it could move down to 570, 560 levels in the days to come. So most of these stocks right now are showing mixed signals. There's GAIL, which is looking good. GAIL can move up to 450, so that's one stock which is showing strength as of now. Then there's IGL, which is again showing strength, has got support around 800, 815. For the last few weeks, it's been consolidating. I think this stock should be able to move up again to 880, 890 in the days to come.
Mandar, I don't know if I asked you for your list of stocks, if you're pretty kind enough to share them, but also if you can tell us if you're talking about a day trade or a trade with a longer term horizon.
So first let's look at positional trades. So on the long side, in case of positional trade, first is Engineers India. This stock has been showing strength lately. Downside support comes in between 290 and 278. Upside targets and the next resistance is between 330 and 335. So this is one good stock on the long side in the short term. Another stock which one can look at is Cairn. The stock has got a resistance between 261 and 263. Once the stock manages to break this resistance, the stock can move to 300. So this is a stock which one needs to watch on the long side again. And on the short side, Tata Motors is one stock which I'm watching. The stock looks weak, has a support at 445. If the support is broken, then on the downside, the targets could be 400, 380. So this is on the short side. From an investment point of view, there are two stocks which are looking good. First is Moil. This stock has formed a rounding bottom formation on the monthly closing charts, monthly closing of November. Therefore, it looks good to buy. Stop loss 328, target 460 from an investment point of view. And the second stock is Bharat Electronics. This stock has managed to break a multiple top resistance at 1380. Therefore, this looks good to buy. Stop loss 1340, target 1550.
Mandar, if you've taken a look at Jubilant Industries, I wanted to put up the chart also because this was an excellent chart. I don't know if it's continued. Kohinoor Foods, I haven't seen the chart, so please go ahead and share your views. Visa Steel and also AllSec Securities.
Yeah, AllSec Securities was trading good volumes yesterday. This stock for the last 1 year has shown good momentum. The stock has moved up from levels of 25-30 to current levels of 350. At current levels, there's a resistance between 360. Yesterday, the stock moved up with good volumes, but by the end of the day, the stock had given up all its gains. So it moved up to 380 and then it came down back to close down at 356. So this band between 360 and 380 becomes a resistance band for the stock. But yes, the momentum continues to remain up. So the stock, till the time the stock trades above 300, 310, the stock could see some more upside. So targets of 450, 500 are quite possible in the days to come. Visa Steel, for the last 2 years, has not, for the last 2-3 years, the stock has not performed. It's continuously faced resistance between 21 and 25 levels. So that's a supply zone for the stock. So the real interest would come back only once the stock crosses this level. In case of Kohinoor Foods also has been trading dull for now. Not much of a move. You get those spurts once off, and then again the stock fizzles out. So nothing much in Kohinoor Foods as of now. Jubilant Industries for the last few days has been trading in a good momentum. Throughout this year, the stock has seen an up move from 140 to 320. But at current levels, it's trading at those all-time high levels. So that's a resistance at around 325 and 330. So there's a resistance there. Once this 330 level is broken, then yes, there could be re-rating in the stock and we could have higher targets as well. But as of now, watch your target of 330 for the stock immediately on short-term basis.
Mandar, first let me just take the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty, can we just put that up and see if there is any significant fall in the Bank Nifty? Yeah, there is. It's a 199 points. So, look, if it can't really hold at these points, you will see it getting to 17,400, maybe even 17,000. You know, Mandar, one of the things that I was checking with Mohit and Mr. Subramanian also was that, you know, till before November 8th, we largely had an uptrend market in which, you know, you had a little bit of a downtake and then again the trend continued. What I find now is that this market is now, the trend is not clear. We're not clear. Maybe it's gotten into a range, which is what markets do for a very long time. What's your thought on that, Mandar? Because range markets aren't the greatest to, you know, make great amounts of money. Then you're basically stuck in a channel.
Yeah, rightly said, Ashu. See, basically, if you look at the long-term chart of the Bank Nifty, the uptrend continues. So it trades in that higher top, higher bottom formation. Now, the only thing is that, yes, the highs that it made at around 20,400 and 20,800, that high becomes a tough resistance for the Bank Nifty going forward. But as the uptrend has been arrested, I think the downside also is limited. So on short-term charts, 18,140 is surely a support level, which if broken, the Bank Nifty could see a downfall of 1,000 points thereon. So 17,000 could be an immediate sell-off and the next level for the Bank Nifty. But for now, the markets, the index would continue to be in a range, as you've said. So the bias remains sideways to weak for now. But during this period, we also could have stocks which are out of the index, which could perform. So basically, it's a script specific market for now as the index consolidates without fresh triggers to make new highs.
Mandar, thanks for joining us with your views today. Subramanian, have a great weekend. Thanks for joining us. And Mohit, as usual.